the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
May the divine assistance remain always with us.
And may the souls of faithfully departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen.
Prayer to St. Michael the Archangel.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him who humbly pray, and may the all prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power of God, cast into hell Satan and all these spirits who run throughout the world seeking the merciful souls. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good evening and welcome to St. Margaret's Dalton Catholic Parish. Our opening hymn is number 270, O God, our help in the ages past, number 270.
sisters, as we come before God, we are grateful for our gifts, thankful for His many blessings. We come before God, too, very sorrowful for our sins. And so we begin holy mass worthily by calling to mind our faults. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after us, and make us always determined to carry out your good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Because the splendor of her never yields.
Yet all good things come together, came to me in her company, and countless riches at her hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, indeed the word of God is living and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating even between soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. No creature is concealed from him, but everything is naked and exposed to the eyes of him to whom we must render an account. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come and follow me." At that statement, the young man's face fell, and he went away sad, for he had many possessions. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it is for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." The disciples were amazed at Jesus' words. So Jesus said to them again and replied, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." They were exceedingly astonished and said among themselves, "Then who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For human beings it is impossible, but not for God. For God, all things are possible." Peter then began to say to Jesus, "We have given up everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or land for my sake and for the sake of the gospel, who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and land with persecution and eternal life in the age to come." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sometime in the first semester of my freshman year in high school, I came home from school, and I was just tired. I was so tired, I went to lay on the couch. My mother looked at me and she said, "Son, we're going to the doctor tomorrow morning. I know that you have a mono. You know, mono, don't you? Mono." Yeah. And so I went, and the next morning I got tested for mono. I'm like, "Gosh, how did you know? You know how she did? She knew me." That's how she did. I guess I wasn't going to have it. It was coming on the one now. So it is, beloved, that our blessed Savior knew that young man. He knew it. And when the boy said, "Lord, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus knew he had to give up his earthly possessions. Notice, if you will, that is not a command that Jesus gives to everyone in the gospel. I mean, there are people, it even says that wealthy people who took care of Jesus out of their own possessions. So it's clearly not that Jesus commands everyone of the disciples to follow him by giving up everything they possess. But he knew that man, and he knew that's what that man needed to inherit eternal life. And so it's a very personal question with a very personalized answer. So I'll give you a few reflections. Listen up. First of all, clearly, Jesus expects us to use our material possessions to build the kingdom of God. Everything we have, materially speaking, is a blessing from God. Therefore, he expects us to use what we have received relative to that which he's given us to build his kingdom. Amen?
Amen.
That's for sure. The second thing is this. What we are called give up is to inherit the kingdom of heaven is very personal for you and me. So the question that you and I must ask ourselves is, what must we sacrifice? What must we give up? What obstacle is there in our lives that is keeping us from inheriting eternal life? That's a personal question and a personal answer that can only be figured out through the grace of wisdom. That's why the scripture says today, I beg for wisdom, for gold itself pale in comparison. Or as Father Zoghby, my cousin, used to say, have you ever seen a U-Haul truck following a hearse? In other words, that young man, it was his money that was keeping him from following the Lord. The Lord looked at him with love. He looks at every one of us with love because he knows us. He knows what's the obstacle in our life to full life with him. Next, he says, why do you call me good? Only God is good. And then he says, with God, all things are possible, but salvation comes through him. If there is, beloved, any obstacle in our life, anything keeping us from salvation, be assured the grace of God is being poured into your soul to overcome that. Because God wants to live with every promise in heaven. So whatever it is today, whatever it is 3 years from now, whatever it is 20 years from now, there will always be sufficient grace to give that up to follow the Lord. Amen? Amen. Because why? Mama and Dad, mononucleosis. Our Father in heaven knows everything about every one of us. He was in our mother's womb creating us when she didn't even know she was coming among us. So whatever grace we need, because salvation comes from God, to inherit eternal life, God has given us. Amen?
Amen.
The last thing, God has a very good memory. First of all, I want to tell you a funny story about my memory. Would you like to hear a funny story? I have a very good friend who grew up in a small town. And he, in his town, was a doctor. And the doctor was the kind of doctor that, you know, with the doctor in a small town, he delivered babies. He was the pediatrician. He was the guy who diagnosed people with cancer. He was the small town doctor. And so this friend of mine's mother went a little much later in life, and he looked at his patient who had been seeing for 30 years and said, honey, you have got to lose weight. She said, Doctor, be careful what you said. You told me when I was expecting my third child, commenting upon myself. And said, you know, you have a memory like an elephant, so watch what you say. And he said, I remember telling you that. And I said, now, you got a body match.
Whoa.
I just had to tell you that. And it's not like you got Peter says, we've given him everything. He said, the Lord, you cannot outdo me in generosity. Because I will remember everything you've done in my name. Whatever sacrifice you make for me, whether it be to give up mother, father, sister, brother, land, I will remember. You will be repaid. Not just with eternal life, but here and now. Because God has an excellent memory. So don't be afraid to sacrifice for him. He remembers our goodness done in his name. Amen?
Amen.
Get busy.
Together we confess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and him, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. Dwelt among the Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified on the Christ's body. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not know him. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Our Father is very good for us. In confidence, we offer our prayers of petition.
To use our material goods to build God's kingdom through charity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to give up anything that keeps us from following Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the end of abortion in our country and throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection of all who protect us, our police officers, firefighters, first responders, and members of the military, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the happy repose of souls of our deceased relatives and friends, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer to the Lord our prayers and our desires. Dear Father, we thank you for your gifts to us and offer these prayers in confidence in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and dwells with us, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Sacrificial offerings
and through these acts of our devotion, may be passed over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the power of the Holy Spirit and the blood of your Son, you gathered them to be your church, to praise you in your manifold wisdom. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, the most chaste spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through and with and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
number 273.
Jesus, Father,
majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so may you make us sharers of his divine nature, for he lives and reigns forever and ever. This evening, we're delighted that you've come to be with us for Mass. If you've been coming to the parish a while or have moved to the area, please join our parish at membership forms in the vestibule. Take one, pull it out, put it in the collection, or you can join online at our website. So we have 3 families joining this week, so thank you for listening. That's wonderful, and welcome. A couple of things, good ones. We have a few seats left still in the bus going to the pretty churches of Mobile. October 21st, so see Diane's number in the bulletin and give her a call. Also, you'll see a sign-up sheet in the vestibule after Mass. So we're going to have 24th, this is October, which is the month, it's called Respect Life Month. We'll be having a rosary, by the way, just after Mass, for the purpose of the end of abortion and all crimes against humanity at the Shrine of Our Lady of Fallon, just on the other side of that green building. So we'll get together right after Mass and pray the Holy Rosary. But we're going to have 24 hours of adoration, which is coming up the October 22nd after morning Mass, all the way through the day and night of Friday to Saturday morning, the 23rd of October. So it's 24 hours of adoration with a specific intention of overturning abortion in our country. We are that close. Who would have ever thought that one of our states, Texas, would have a bill basically outlawing abortion after the heartbeat of the baby? Jesus says, when the apostles came back from expelling demons and curing the ill, they said, Jesus, there were some illnesses we couldn't cure and some demons we could not expel. And he said, you know why? He said, because some things are only accomplished by prayer and fasting. So please sign up for an hour to pray for that particular intention. We're that close. If one case they can do it, and the Supreme Court has allowed that law to stay in effect, and a federal appeals court has supported it. We're that close. We have to pray for the end of abortion. So sign up after Mass. It'll be Friday the 22nd and 23rd of October. See, that's all. Enjoy the rest of this beautiful evening. Please have a good final blessing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended, go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The divine grace is for protection against storms and hurricanes. Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, the God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed
be Jesus, the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, verily.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, and most holy.
Blessed be her holy Immaculate Conception.
Blessed be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin Mother.
Blessed be St. Joseph of the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God, and his angels, and his saints.